Hello everybody, it's time for Cooking with Uncle Marc. Yes folks, we have a fantastic show for you today. As you can see, I've got my Christmas tree on, so we're ready to make some presents for all those good little boys and good little girls, and even more for those naughty little boys and naughty little girls. And we have a special guest with us today, our little helper just down from the North Pole, Marta, come on out! Yay! So glad you could join us! Well, we are going to have one heck of a show today. We're going to be making something so good. The kids will want to make it. It's easy to do. They're called Italian Christmas cookies. You ever had them? Well, they're right there in our cookbook. Uncle Marc's cookbook is on Barnes & Noble, and we're going to take that recipe out there, and we're going to make something special for you today on that. So, let's go ahead, and of course, we always start off with a little sip of, since it's a dessert, we'll have a dessert wine. Won't you think? A little dessert wine?
Oh, yes, yes. Ching ching.
A ching ching. Oh my, that's delicious.
Oh, famos.
So, what we have, we've done a few steps ahead of time to kind of save you a little bit of the lengthy delay that it takes to go ahead and make Christmas cookies. And what we've got for you is the dough is already prepared. So you won't have to do that, but I'll tell you everything that's in it. And we are going with the Grinch theme today. We made our dough green. You can make this dough any color that you want and make it in a variety array of the colors. Your frosting's in chain, so it's fun. You get the kids out, you decorate, and it's like, get your hands in there, get them all gooey and so forth. So
right.
We've got these already, and what you've got, what goes into these, you know, look, Santa took away some of my salt this year. Let's see, it takes 5 cups of all-purpose flour. You take 2 tablespoons and 1.5 tablespoons of baking powder. You put butter extract, 1.5 teaspoons of butter extract, 3/4 teaspoons of rum extract, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1.5 teaspoons of lemon extract, 6 eggs, and 1 cup of shortening, and 2 cups of confectionery sugar. And you mix all that together. You'll mix your dry ingredients together first, then mix your wet ingredients together and add your dry ingredients to it. So that's quite simple. It doesn't take too long to do. And what we have is a couple of baking sheets here. And I'm gonna give one to my little helper. And what we're gonna use, just get a little spoon or something for you. And what I want you to do is, I want you to dip your spoon in my batter.
Ooh,
and
right.
Get a little ball out. Okay. Yeah, a little ball of my batter. There you go. And take it and you can just roll it in your hand, make a little ball. Doesn't even have to be that big. And we're just gonna put, that's perfect.
Okay.
And we're gonna take it and we're just gonna plop it down on the thing. And give yourself enough room between your balls so that they don't go together. Nothing worse when your balls meet in the middle, right?
I don't know if I wanna go there.
I don't know how that works. But you know, I hate it when my balls are slapping together. I tell you what, then they cook together and they're all one big mess.
What a mess.
It's terrible. Other thing that we can do is we can make Christmas trees and stars. You can get your little cutouts for you. Here's a little Christmas tree cutout. And one of the easiest things I found to do with this is I just take it and I flatten out my batter. And I'll give you a little star to work with. Okay, and we'll use the cutting board here. And we just take it and we lay it down on here and we get it nice and flat. And take your little cutter and just stick it in, you know, stick it in and wiggle it about a little bit. You know, you want to get it loose.
Mm-hmm.
You can stick it in and wiggle it around.
Oh,
there you
yeah.
go. There you go.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, there you go. Now stick yours in and wiggle it around. There you go.
Oh,
oh there you
so
go.
Satisfying.
It's wonderful. I just love it when that happens. And you just pull it apart and peel off the edges. And gently get the extra dough off. Like this, put it in our thing, and then we have, like I just did a Christmas tree, and you have a nice little pretty Christmas tree, and you put it on your baking sheet, Looks like you stuck a little.
I should have stuck a
you
little
stuck
longer.
You stuck a little longer.
This is the first for me.
It's the first time you've ever stuck to a board?
First time.
Oh, I tell you, when you stick your straw to some wood, I don't know what you're going to do. It's horrible when that happens. So we're going to take these, we're going to roll up a few balls here, and we're going to put out some Christmas trees and some so forth.
Okay.
And I'm gonna let you just play.
I'm start again.
I think we'll get.
Okay, you continue. I don't want to hold you.
Continue.
Up.
Well, while she's doing that, I'm gonna kind of show you one of the things that you do after you get done baking these. They'll bake for 350 degrees for about 12 minutes in your oven, and once you take those out, you're gonna want them, let them cool on a cooling rack. And we've made this ahead of time. This is what you're going to dip these in. This is made with whole milk. It's a frosting that goes over the top of them. And as you can see, we've made green frosting. It's nice and sweet and drippy. Yeah, there we go, nice and sweet and drippy. And it takes a half a cup of whole milk, and you have 3 3/4 cups of confectionery sugar. Don't think, oh God, it's got so much sugar in it, but you want it to come out and be a nice, you know, just kind of runny, so you can take your cookies and dip it in it. And then we have some almond extract, and 1 teaspoon, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And then you can add your food coloring and make it, you know, whatever color you want. Last year I had, several years ago, like 500 and something different cookies made. They were all different colors and so forth. So that was a big amount of fun. So let's put all these on your tray.
Okay.
And then we can fill that one up and slap it in the oven.
Great.
Okay. We'll take this over here and then put this in the oven. There we go. So it'll start cooking for us. And as the magic of the internet, we have some that are already cool. There's some finished, cooled cookies. Now look at that. Nice little Christmas trees. You can hang your balls from it.
Beautiful.
Yes. Great place to hang your balls from a Christmas tree, right? Little
yes.
Red ones and whatever. And what we're going to do is you can take this batter here, the frosting that we've just made. Move this out of the way. You're going to take your cookie and you're going to slowly dip it in your frosting. Just like this. And get the top of it all, you know, covered real well. And then if you've got a rack, you can take it and just put it onto your rack. Mmm, that's really good. Now you try one.
Okay. Do another little tree here.
Yeah. And since I'm playing with the food and licking my fingers, I think I will put on a glove so I don't double dip.
Ah, that was easy.
That was very easy,
love
isn't it? Very, very easy. And then if you've made your little balls, you know, take your ball, you stick it in there, get it covered up with a nice little frosting, and then you put that down on there. And there's a rubber glove over there if you want to put a rubber glove. If you don't mind getting your hands gooey, you can just stick your hand in it. Okay, well, you just stick your hand in it and get it gooey. That's
okay.
Right. Stick your hand in it and get it gooey. I like that idea.
Well,
there we go. And I take mine and dip it in there. Oh, gosh. Try making 500 of these. But these really don't take a lot of time. They're kind of quick, easy to do. And, you know, everybody should have some sort of Christmas cookie or something that they want to do, and they can do it with their kids. And while we're doing that, I want to show you, we have Uncle Marc's cookbook. It's on Barnes & Noble. It's 230 pages, full color. It's got all the recipes in it that we do on the show. And we're going to be doing some special recipes with some guest cooks here in the near future. But you can go on to our Facebook channel and select buy. It'll take you directly to Barnes & Noble. You can go to Barnes & Noble and you can get it from there as well. And if you enjoy the cookbook or like it, make sure you put some comments. We do appreciate it. And we're also on YouTube now. All you got to do is search Uncle Marc. We'd love for you to follow us on YouTube. That'd be great. So, since I've got my naughty hat on, I think it's time for a little sip of the dessert wine. Mm. There we go. Mm. That was so good. And while we're decorating, you ever sprinkle on top of your cookie?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, sprinkle your cookie.
Oh, yeah.
Well, let me see you sprinkle your cookies for me, because she's going to sprinkle them and get some red on there, and this gives it that nice holiday look. You can use any colors that you want, and that way you'll have... let's put some batter on that
one.
Yeah, you missed one with no batter.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, can't have it without any batter on it. Nothing worse than a batterless cookie. There you go. Alrighty. And that way you can.
How fun is
now,
that?
Now you're just gonna take them. You're gonna set them to the side. Let them. They'll dry, and the frosting will dry on them, and they'll be perfect and fantastic. So once they finish, by the magic of the internet, you should have a plate of delicious cookies to try.
That's
nothing
amazing.
they are, and it's like you just start eating them and eating them and eating them. It's like, oh, before you know it, you've done ate a dozen of these damn cookies, and it's like, okay. Nothing worse than filling your mouth full of cookies and your mouth full of cookies. Yeah, fill your mouth full of cookies. And fill your mouth full of
cookies.
Cookies
and wine.
Cookies and wine. Yeah. Okay. Cookies and wine get me in a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
I hate it when I eat too many cookies and wine. All right. Let's grab one. Give it the good old taste test. Let's see here. Mmm. These are so good. So simple to make.
Mm-hmm.
So easy to make. A great holiday cookie just for you and your family. Make a whole batch of them. Make them, give them to your friends. Put in a little Tupperware thing. I did that 1 year. Gave them as Christmas presents. Great Christmas
great
presents.
Idea.
Nothing better than some good old food for a Christmas present. So with my twinkle of my ears and the twist of my hat, we are down to the very final portion of our show for today. And there's one thing that everybody that comes on the show has to learn.
Yeah.
First of all, how to wipe their hands. And then and then second of all, the toast. You've heard this toast before, right?
I think I have.
Well, one of these days, we're going to get you to totally and completely remember it. So come over here close.
Okay.
Here's to it.
Here's to it.
And to it again.
And to it again.
And to the hopes.
To the hopes.
We do it again.
We do it again.
The birds do it.
The birds do it.
The bees do it.
The bees do it.
Even the little fleas do it.
Even the little fleas do it.
And if you can't remember how to do it.
You can't remember how to do it.
You call me and we'll do it to it.
Call me and we'll do it to it.
Keep on cooking.
Ching ching.
Mmm. Until next week, Wednesday is our day of cooking for you. Be sure to tune in. Go to our Facebook channel. Go to our YouTube channel, follow us, like us, be sure that you tell your friends about us. Look up, the Uncle Marc's cookbook is, like I said, on Barnes & Noble. We look forward to seeing you and giving you some more wonderful recipes going forward. And y'all have a wonderful rest of your day.
Ciao, ciao.